All of the gameplay in the background of these videos are side missions from Pandora and Promethea, played on true Vault Hunter mode, which means that there will be no spoilers for the game's story. So you're considering playing Zane? I really don't blame you, he's a lot of fun, but I feel that there's not a lot of information on him and how he plays. In this video we're going to go into detail as more of a beginner guide, going over his abilities, the augments, how they play, but really looking into the skill trees of Zane, showing some actual gameplay of each of them, and giving you the best idea on what to expect if you want to choose him, really looking at the skill trees of Doubled Agent, Hitman, and Undercover, the latter of which is really being slept on by a lot of people, so I kind of wanted to prove them wrong. We mentioned it in the Which Vault Hunter Should You Pick video, but the thing that makes Zane really spark is the fact that he can equip two abilities at once. He loses the ability to use his grenade, but in all honesty, you get a lot more for it, and even some of the abilities that you get can use grenades themselves, so you're not really missing out completely. He's the mix and match hero that is the best at hybrid, but I feel when you mention that about Zane, most people go, oh, he's the jack of all trades, master of none, and that's not strictly true. Before we go into the different playstyles of Zane, let's go over his abilities and the augments that they include. In each of the skill trees, Zane has an ability, and like I said, he can pick two of the following three. In a Doubled Agent tree, you have the digiclone, which spawns a digital copy of Zane. The clone stays in place, but distracts and fires at the enemy. Pressing the button again, whatever he's assigned to, will swap you and the clone where you're stood, meaning that you can use it to sort of zip around, teleporting from place to place. But your digiclone does have health and shield, and it can die, so just be wary of that before you plant it right next to a boss, as an example. The next trait is Hitman with the Sentinel, which sends into battle an automated Sentinel drone that continually flies through the environment and attacks enemies with its machine gun. You can press the button again to give it a kill command, where it would focus the target that you wanted to focus, similar to Flak's pets. And finally, we have the barrier in the Undercover tree. It puts down a deployable barrier that blocks incoming projectiles. It also increases your damage and your team's damage if they fire through it. And you can also pick up and put down the barrier as much as you can in the duration that it has. So from the get-go, you can see how flexible and diverse Zane is, but it gets better. In case you didn't know, in each of the skill trees, as you invest points into it, you unlock augments as you go through each of the tiers. These are things that can change the elemental damage of your ability, can make it so when you use an ability, it regens your health or starts regening your shields, as an example, or can actually change how the ability works as a whole. To give you a good idea on what to expect with Zane, we'll go through each of the augments now, and you can pick two for each ability. But just to be clear, each of the augments only affects the ability in that skill tree. As an example, we have Winter's Drone, which converts the Sentinel's primary weapon to cryo damage. You can't apply this to the digiclone in the other tree, if that makes sense. Again, fairly obvious, but there are a few exceptions to that rule, so it pays to be as clear as possible there. Going over the Doubled Agent tree first, let's go and talk about what you can have with the digiclone. The first is binary system. Whenever Zane swaps places with his clone, a cryo nova is triggered around Zane and the clone. Go down another tier, you go to Schadenfreude. Whenever the clone takes damage, Zane's shield is restored by a portion of that damage. It's down as 100% of the damage that the digiclone takes, but no doubt you can improve this further by specking into specific talents. On the other side of that skill tree, you have Which One's Real. Enemies are more likely to target the clone for a few seconds after it's been summoned and after swapping places, making it the more tanky version if you want to make sure that you're not taking damage. Then you have Doppelbanger. Hold down the action button of the digiclone to end the action skill early. The clone explodes, dealing splash damage to all nearby enemies. Alongside that, you have Digital Distribution. If Zane takes health damage while the clone is active, a portion of that damage is shared to the clone instead, 75% to be exact. And like I said, you could pick two of the five augments that we've gone over here for the digiclone. Moving on to Hitscan with the Sentinel, what augments can you get for it? Well, we mentioned the first one already. Winter's Drone converts Sentinel's primary weapon to cryo damage. As you progress into the third tier, you'll come across Bad Dose. Sentinel occasionally shoots out a beam of radiation that weakens enemies and buffs Zane. For every weakened enemy, Zane's movement speed and fire rate are increased by a set amount. Weakened enemies have decreased movement speed and attack speed, so you get increased fire rate, movement speed, and damage for a duration of about 12 seconds. That's subject to change, of course, depending on how you spec. On the other side of the tree, we have Static Field. Sentinel emits a static field that sends a shock beam to nearby enemies, draining their shields and replenishing Zane's. Go down another tier, you get Boomstay. Sentinel adds a rocket pod to its primary weapons, allowing it to shoot rockets as well as machine guns. And finally, Almighty Ordnance. Hold down the action button again while the Sentinel is deployed to paint a target area. The Sentinel fires a missile barrage at that area, and if an enemy is killed, Sentinel's duration is reset. You can only do this once per action skill use. And finally, Undercover with the barrier, what can you do there? The first one is Charged Relay. Whenever Zane or an ally touch the barrier, they gain increased movement speed and reload speed for a few seconds. The next one I kind of want to do in an Irish accent, but I shouldn't, but Nanites or some shite. Zane and his allies gain health regen, increased reload speed, and greatly improved shield recharge delay whilst near the barrier. The lower the health, the more health is regenerated, which is honestly too good not to use. Next up with that is Allrounder. It turns the barrier into a dome, covering all sides, so you kind of become Winston from Overwatch. We then move on to Retaliation. Zane and allies near the barrier gain increased gun damage by 10% for a few seconds after the barrier takes damage. Deterrence Field is also next. Enemies that touch the barrier take shock damage and are staggered. I'm pretty sure it's impossible to kill the barrier, I'm not 100% sure, but I have seen it take a lot of damage and still survive, making it really good at just surviving, really. As you get into the higher tier content, we'll talk about this a little bit more in like an endgame Zane video, but it feels like this is a skill tree that you often rely on more than you'd expect. But we can talk about builds and playstyles now as we go into each of the skill trees. Unlike the other characters, you don't really want to be dedicating to one skill tree as a whole. Once you're leveling, you kind of have to as Zane or anybody else, but for Zane, it's more about creating hybrid builds between the three trees and augmenting the two abilities that you have. For Amara, as an example, you might put all of the points that you have at level 50 into Brawl, and that would make a lot of sense, to an extent at least. But for Zane, you don't want to do that. At level 50, you want to be getting to your capstone on one of the trees, and then maybe dedicating all of the other points into another tree to make the ability in that tree a lot better with the augments that you may be using, and to just get some extra talents to make you a little bit better in certain regards. You want to be going like 60 to 75% in your main tree, 25 to 40% in another one. You can split between each three of the trees, making some like trio hybrid build, because the capstones for Zane as a whole aren't amazing. But let's talk about Doubled Agent. It's the tree that has a big focus on your digiclone, the damage that it can do, the abilities as a whole, making sure that they're up as often as possible, and increasing your damage as much as possible. But there's also a good amount of stuff when it comes to survivability, shield regen, and making sure that your digiclone is taking the brunt of the damage. The capstone is that your digiclone will have the same weapon as you were holding when you summon it. It won't change when you change weapons, so be smart about using it. So it's an okay capstone, but it does rely on you having some pretty broken weapons to make the most of it. That's how I feel Zane really strives. You get a really bizarre anointed weapon or really crazy legendary or a class mod, and you can go, I'm going to break the game with this kind of stuff. You know, like a legendary weapon, having your digiclone equip it might make it do a tremendous amount of damage. But if you don't have those anointed gear, the legendary guns, the class mods, like I'm showing you on screen, it's pretty flat. You know, it's still strong, but the playstyle in general is a lot slower than the other trees. But I'd like to call it slow and steady. It's really good for leveling because you always have an option. You take a lot of damage, you can sort of bring out the digiclone, they can tank for you. You have decent shield regeneration and health regen. Not the best, but it ultimately comes down to if you like the digiclone. Do you want it up quite frequently? Do you want it to do a lot of damage and provide utility to both you and your team? It's definitely the middle of the pack option between the high offensive Sentinel and a very defensive option of the barrier. But this whole skill tree dedicates a lot to the digiclone. So if you're not really interested in it, you can certainly avoid it. The good thing about this tree though is a lot of the strong talents are very early in the tree, increasing your action skill duration, health regen and gun damage increase whenever you kill something, increasing your gun damage per active action skill. They roll relatively low in this tree, which means that you could just throw in a couple of points to get some pretty impactful talents. But the Doubled Agent, in short, is the happy medium between a very offensive playstyle of Hitman and a conservative undercover class. But of course, like I mentioned, the best part about Zane is you compare this happy medium of the Doubled Agent skill tree with more offensive options in Hitman or more defensive options in Undercover. It really tailors to your playstyle. But you're definitely not as mobile, which makes it suck, like I mentioned in stuff like Proving Grounds or faster playthroughs. Going over the Hitman tree, this is all about kill skills. The idea of when you kill somebody, you get buffed in a multitude of ways. It could be your movement speed, it could be your reload speed, gaining lifesteal, increasing your fire rate, increasing your action skill duration. All of these things you could do from killing people. This is really good in those areas like Proving Grounds or certain leveling areas where you are constantly killing squishy enemies, which means that you have 100% uptime of all of these skill trees, making you really strong. It's just a really good mobbing version of Zane, as you've seen on screen, how fast and agile he is. But you definitely notice those moments where those kill skills run out. You could run into a badass that's a lot more difficult to take down, or a boss where there's no mobs to kill. You can't activate any of these kill skills unless you go into the capstone of Hitman, which is seen in red. When you activate an action skill, it automatically activates all of Zane's kill skills. You use the Sentinel, the Barrier, the Digiclone, whatever, you will activate all of those buffs that I just mentioned without needing to kill stuff. So if you're one of those players that really likes to keep your procs up as long as possible, this is the playstyle for you. And it's a lot of fun when you're just out and about leveling, playing in Mayhem mode. Proving Grounds, I haven't actually tried it yet, but I can imagine it being quite strong when you have the right gear. The Sentinel is the most offensive option, so you have somebody that can do a lot of damage running alongside you, but also it provides a lot of elemental utility. Like we went over with the augments, you can change the primary weapon to do cryo damage, to do radiation damage, or to do shock beams that drain enemy shields. It means that if you run into armor targets, you have an option. If you run into high shielded targets, you have an option. You can be quite flexible with your elements. But the cooldown on Sentinel is quite long in comparison to the other ones. So if you dedicate fully to this tree, you have big offensive capabilities, high mobility as an example, but you do lack a bit of survivability. Now you could pair this with the doubled agent trees we just mentioned, which would make it even more damage orientated, but very glass cannony to an extent at least. Or you could pair it with Undercover, where you have the Barrier, use it to provide yourself shields, health regen, which works surprisingly well. You're moving a lot when you're playing in the Hitman tree, but for Undercover with the Barrier, you might slow down a bit, which might seem very counterintuitive. A high mobility tree mixed with a slow one doesn't really work. You'd be surprised. You're watching that gameplay on screen right now, where how quickly you could dive between people, bring out the barrier when you need a little bit more healing, but of course bringing out that barrier increases your damage because of the seen red capstone, which is a playstyle that I really want to dedicate more time to playing. Get a really good shotgun, you're running around like crazy. Next we'll go over Undercover. This is a tree that I feel people scoff at just because it's all based around keeping your shield health up, your shield regen. Oh, it's all about surviving, boring, let's dedicate more points to the damage trees and the broken stuff that Zane can do. And that's all very well good when people are theory crafting builds for endgame, but you do need that element of survivability. And the idea that this tree doesn't do any damage is just flat out wrong. Fair enough, the first couple of tiers are all about keeping your recharge rate up on your shield, even increasing the maximum shield capacity, gaining damage resistance, but as you get past the sort of midway point of this tree into confident competence, whilst your shields are active, you gain increased gun damage and accuracy, which is based on the amount of shields that you have. The more percent full, the greater bonus. Of course, this tree has a lot to do with the 100% uptime Zane build that people like Baru have looked at, but mostly the ice-orientated version of Zane, because you have calm, cool, and collected in this tree. When you freeze an enemy, your shields start recharging instantly. If the shields are already full, your health regenerates for a few seconds. If your health and shield is full, the action skill cooldown and durations are immediately reset. So the whole basis of this tree is keep your health and your shields up, and if you can do that, which is harder than you think, obviously, you get a lot of benefits to increased gun damage, action skill duration being the longest out of everyone. And if you can play it right, your Sentinel, your Barrier, your Digiclone will be out a lot. I almost forgot to mention the capstone for Undercover. Zane's barrier gains the effect of his current equipped shield mod. Additionally, shield effects also apply to targets near the barrier. Bonuses to Zane are reduced. But this is the best way to explain Zane. He has some really strong bits of kit that often rely on having amazing shield mods, like we've gone over with his skill tree. You might get a legendary shield mod that does amazing stuff for your build, and having this capstone alongside makes it even more brokenly strong. This capstone is pretty bad if you don't have the right gear, and that kind of feels how Zane is. This might make Zane one of the hardest heroes to play in general, but I can't wait to see really good Zane players doing the stuff that I just mentioned. So if you want a challenge and a not straightforward character to play, then Zane is the option. You've been seeing the gameplay on screen at level 46, 47, and there were times that I was really struggling because I didn't have a really good legendary weapon that fit what I was doing. When certain elements of your build aren't in place, you definitely feel like it's not there. But I definitely have that sense of once you get the right legendary class mods, the right anointed weapons, the right talent for a certain build, Zane is going to be nutty. I can sense it, I can feel it. But if you also want to dedicate more time to playing Zane, here are a few things that you need to be aware of. Like I just went over, he is the most undefined character. There's no straightforward builds. That won't last forever. As you start getting really good gear, you are going to surpass everyone. That's kind of the fun of Zane. That's why I've dedicated the most time to him than anybody else. You do struggle with ammo regen in comparison to some of the other Vault Hunters. The cornerstones as a whole are fine, but not incredibly amazing. But of course, the biggest weakness is that you do hit a ceiling without the right gear or talent. You might be watching a gameplay in the background, for example, and thinking, this isn't as exciting as Flak or Amara or Moz, but I don't have any legendary guns, I don't have any legendary mods. I can promise you when I get that, things are going to change. So if that element of playstyle really excites you for playing Zane, go for it. But I hope you enjoyed this video. Do like and subscribe for more Borderlands content. More guides and stuff should be going out over the next couple of days. These do take a lot of time to make, as you can imagine. But thanks for watching, take care, see you soon.